Hi guys, welcome to my channel Made by Mackenzie. I'm Mackenzie and today is the first day of 2024. Yay! Insert fireworks or sparklers or confetti. See if I can insert that. You'll figure it out if I was able to actually do that or not. But I'm so excited for the beginning of the new year. And because it's the beginning of the new year, we are going to talk about all of the goals and things that I have planned for my business for this upcoming year. And some of these things, if you guys find that they're helpful to you, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and let me know if you find some of these things helpful. But so some of these things are going to be personal to me, what I think that I need, and then I will go through some suggestions of what could be beneficial to you during this upcoming year for all of us crafters and crocheters and anyone else who finds this video informative. So let's get started. So for me, one of the main things that I want to do is I want to have my booth display pretty much set in stone by the end of 2024. I want to make sure that I have all the correct tablecloths that I like. If you saw some of my previous videos, you'll know that I could not find a good like fitted tablecloth. So I need to find that. I also want to get a banner for the front of said 5-foot table. And then I also want to get some stamps that have my logo on it to put on my brown gift bags, just to make it look more professional than just having, you know, a plain gift bag. I think it's time that I need to up that display in that to make it look better. So that's number one. I want all of that to be done, and any other like tubs or tins or signs that I want all of that to be done by the end of this year. The next thing that I am guilty of is I'm not a huge social media person, so like Facebook, Instagram, and even like just starting this YouTube channel, I was kind of really intimidated by it, but I need to be better at posting on Instagram and Facebook. And so I put a goal for me to do 2 posts a week. I think I can do that. And along with that, I need to take better product images, professional ones, like either outside in the backyard or go to the park and take better product images to use in those said Facebook or Instagram posts. And then also when it comes to being on YouTube here, I also want to be better at posting like reels or shorts, just little short clips, which I need to get better at doing that as well. The next thing I want to do is I need to be a little bit better at documenting my receipts. I'm not terrible at it or bad, but I know that a couple of them have fallen through the cracks, and especially whenever we go to file our taxes. Some of these things that I have purchased that I've since, like, I misplaced the receipt for, you know, I could have put that towards the stuff for your business, the things that you buy that are for your business that could be, you know, you could get tax deductible is not the right word, that's insurance, but you know what I'm trying to say. I can't remember what it was called. But so that is one of the things. And then also get better at tracking my mileage. So I track my mileage when I go to craft fairs and whenever I come back, but I don't track it if I go out to like purchase yarn. And so I need to start doing that and documenting those mileage of the gas that I use whenever I go to actually purchase yarn from stores or anything like that. The next thing that I want to do is this year, I want to design a new pattern and put out a new pattern. I'm not going to, the candy cane pattern that I'm probably going to release in July doesn't count because I was supposed to do it last year, but since I hurt my wrist, it didn't get put up. So that one doesn't count. I have to come up with a new original one. So I do have that as one of my goals. So that is everything that I have, like my big ones that I have planned So this next section is going to be something that could work for you guys, for some goals that you can set for yourself. So the first thing I have is, I was thinking about this and I decided it wasn't going to work for me, but have a set number of craft fairs that you want to do for the whole year. So I was thinking last year I did 5 and 6 months, so I'm like, maybe I should strive for 10 and 12 months. But I've told you guys before, I'm picky with my craft fairs, and I didn't want to force myself to go to a craft fair just to complete this goal of, you know, going to 10 and 12 months. But if that works for you guys, that is great. Set those goals. But just for me personally, I didn't think that, I think that was just too much. If I find a craft fair that I think I'm going to be successful at, then I will sign up for it, but I'm not going to have like a set amount that I need to, go to in a year. The next one is to crochet every day. That can be a goal if you're just starting to learn or get into it. You know, one of the things is practicing, especially when it comes to like your yarn tension. I've mentioned this before, yarn tension, like I feel like crochet is like 90% yarn tension. Like how you hold your working yarn in your hand is gonna make all the difference with creating your project. So if you're having a hard time with things, practice, practice, practice. So just set a certain amount of time each day that you want to practice something, and then set it aside, and then come back to tomorrow and do it all over again. So do that. Learn a new stitch or technique. So me, I have a hard time with the herringbone stitch, and I'll see if I can show a picture of what it is on the screen, but I have a hard time with the herringbone stitch. So I want to get better at that this year. And then also I want to, in the technique, I want to try to do a corner to corner, like wall hanging. They have corner to corner blankets, which are bigger, but I don't really need any blankets. So I'm going to do something kind of like this, like a wall hanging artwork that's corner to corner, because I've never done that technique before. So I wanted to try that. Try a new pattern. Doesn't have to be, you know, something super complicated, or just, you know, try a pattern that you've never done before. Or like if you're used to doing like flat projects like washcloths and clothes and things like that, you know, maybe you should try doing plushies and amigurumi, or vice versa. Or, you know, I think I might try to do like a little shrug or a shawl this year. But, you know, try something that you're intimidated by, and just to see how it goes. The next thing is, there are tons of videos on YouTube and people that have these crochet along videos. So if you're just starting out, or if you just kind of want to follow along with someone doing a pattern, that's also a great goal to have, to do some crochet along videos. The next thing is, finish all your work in progresses. As crocheters, we have a lot that are work in progress. We have like a huge bag full of things that we haven't quite finished. So set a goal to finish some of those items that are in your work in progress bags. If you are just starting out crocheting and you're kind of thinking that, you know, you want to progress in this, sign up for your first craft fair. Try to sell some of your crochet. That can be a great goal to set. And, you know, you can do it at craft fairs or farmers markets, or, you know, little events like that. But set a goal that if you think this is the year that you are going to take that step, that is a great goal to have. Use yarn from your yarn stash before you go out and buy new yarn. I think that's a very hard goal for us crocheters, to use up our yarn stash before we go out and buy. But if that's something that you want to try, give it a go. That is definitely not something that I can do. Whenever I see new yarn or things that I have to go out, and get it. Let's see here. Okay. So we've talked about kind of some ideas. Now we're going to go through some tips on how to keep our goals. So first things first is to write it down. And once you write it down, make sure that it's achievable. It's something that you can do, but it's also kind of a challenge. So a challenge, but achievable. So write it down. Make it so that you will see it all the time to remind yourself of what you are striving to do. You can, you know, post it on your refrigerator. You can put it up on your phone, on your screen of your phone, right? Whenever you open your phone, you can see what your goal is. You can put it on, write it on your bathroom mirror. I mean, just let people know what your goal is, and let them know, hey, this is what my goal is. I need you to ask me about my goal from time to time to see how I'm doing, if I'm progressing and keeping track of my goal and doing what I said I was going to do. The next thing is to, if yours is a pretty big goal, break it down into manageable steps. So like if your goal is to start crocheting, step one, you know, research and get supplies. Step two, find, you know, your first YouTube video or something that you want to try and follow along to, or, you know, break it down into little steps. Also, I said earlier, set time limits. So like if you're going to try to crochet every day, it's like, okay, I'm going to crochet 30 minutes every day, 15 minutes every day, 10 minutes every day. Set a time limit, or you can set like a milestone. So for example, if you've decided that you're going to make like a coat or a cardigan or something like that, like be like, okay, my first milestone is after I crochet the arm will be my first one, and then my second arm, and then the front panel, and then the back panel. So break it up into milestones like that. Or if you want to do like, okay, 10 rows or 20 rows, that'll be your milestone for the day. Or if you're doing something like granny squares, you can pick like how many granny squares that you want to make. So like, oh, I'm going to do 3 granny squares every day, and then I'll be able to make a granny square blanket or whatever it is that you guys are wanting to do. The next thing is to keep an inspirational quote or something in your head or just in mind, or even on that bathroom mirror, for the times whenever you do fall short, because we are human, we make mistakes, we get busy, things happen, and that is okay. So just make sure you have like a quote for whenever you get off track. Like, you know, I'm not perfect, but at least I'm progressing, or something like that to inspire you to keep going even whenever, you know, you might fail, and that's okay. The next thing is to celebrate your achievements. Celebrate hitting those milestones. Oh, look, I finished the arm, or I was able to get the first part of my granny square blanket together. And there are so many people on Facebook and social medias that you can post your work, especially like if you're beginning, there's quite a few beginner crochet groups and just different things like that, where you can post like, wait, I've just started, look what I've done. And you will get so much praise, because we're so happy to invite you guys to our community of crafters. And we're glad to see the work that you guys put in with your craft. And so anyways, but that is everything that I have. If you guys have any other suggestions of either like some goals that you could set, or some ways to keep those goals, different ideas on to make sure that you hit your goals, or, you know, so that you don't get discouraged or things like that, you know, post those in the comment section below. And thank you guys so much for watching. I hope we have an amazing year of 2024. See you guys later. Bye.